future. So in terms of the transportation budget, one of the things, we're still in the middle of negotiations. We'll hopefully see it come out of the House next Wednesday. But one of the pieces that I think is extremely important in terms of our economic development and business growth is we're setting ourselves up for new industries that are coming into the state, into the various regions, but also existing, is how do we connect our workforce to where the jobs are. In many parts of the state, that of course is investing in our public transit. This particular transportation budget, not only are we investing in those public transit systems, but specifically targeting some of those investments, close to $30 million specifically for workforce initiatives. So that is specifically taking our workforce and connecting them to those job sites. But of course, we know that many of the new industries that are moving into the state, they're not always moving into established neighborhoods. We also have to work on our infrastructure needs, and one of the things that we are looking forward to working with the speaker on, still, you know, working out the details of this, is creating that whole transportation fund that specifically will target in many of our non-urban areas, you know, how do we make sure that those projects move forward. Not only is this great for moving people to jobs, but we also know many of those things, like for example, if we're trying to connect people to recovery supports, you know, having good connections between communities is something that that we need and always still prioritize in our transportation budget. Thinking forward to the state's operating budget, you know, I will tell you there are many things that we were quite pleased to see that the governor has prioritized that to me are important economic drivers. For example, you know, certainly the investing in our workforce, but even those quality of life issues, making sure that Ohio, not only is it good for business, but more importantly, that we're good for our workers, and we're making this place a great state to live. And things like making sure that we're supporting, for example, access to quality, affordable childcare. We know, especially coming out of this pandemic, that the importance of childcare, not only is it great for the development of our children as they move through early childhood, but this is an important economic issue to make sure that we are able to get people and keep people in their jobs and stay in those jobs. Also for us, a huge priority is making sure that we are fully investing and funding public education in this state. Last General Assembly, we